Welcome to the Batavia Fine Arts Center, bringing the arts to life. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with the nearest emergency exit. In the event of an emergency, please proceed calmly to the nearest exit and do not use the elevator. Food and drink are not permitted within the theater. Please consume all concessions in the lobby before entering. At this time, we ask you to assure all cellular devices are turned off, as texting, talking and web surfing are strictly prohibited during the performance. Also note that photography and video recording are not permitted. We thank you for joining us today and hope to see you again soon. Enjoy the performance.
We shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time.
Are you blind when you're born?
Can you see in the dark? Can you look at a king?
Would you sit on his throne?
Can you say of your bite that it's worse than your bark?
Are you cock of the walk?
When you're walking alone,
because jellicles are and jellicles do. Jellicles do and jellicles will. Jellicles will and jellicles can. Jellicles can and jellicles do.
When you fall on your head, do you land on your feet?
Are you tense when you sense there's a storm in the air?
Street.
Do you know how to go?
And be sign there.
Because jellicles can, and jellicles do. Jellicles do, and jellicles can. Jellicles can, and jellicles do. Jellicles do, and jellicles can. Jellicles can, and jellicles do.
Can you ride on a broomstick to places far distant?
Can look.
Look and with bow.
Were you waiting to this brand?
Are you in and out? In and out.
Are you mean like a minx?
Are you mean like a minx?
Are you keen to be seen when you're smelling a rat?
There in the Pharaoh's condition of this.
If you are and you are, you're a jellicle cast. Jellicle songs for 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 jellicle cast.
Oh!
there's a man over there with a look of surprise, as much as to say, well, how about that?
Do I actually see with my own very eyes a man who's not heard of a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat?
What's a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat?
The naming of cats is a difficult matter. It isn't just one of your holiday names. You may think at first I'm as mad as a hatter when I tell you a cat must have pretty different names. First of all, there's the name of the family you stay, such as Peter, Augustus, Alonzo, or James, such as Victor, or Jonathan, George, or the baby, but all of them sensible, everyday names. There are fancier names, if you think they sound sweeter. Some for the gentlemen, some for the dames, such as Plato, Admetus, Electra, Demeter, but all of them sensible, everyday names. But I tell you, a cat, he's a name that's particular, a name that's peculiar and more dignified. Else how can he keep up his tail perpendicular, or spread out his whiskers, or cherish his pride? Of names of this kind, I can give you a quorum, such as Nuncus Jacquato, or Corico Cat, such as Bon Ballerina, or else Jerinorum. He's a never belong to more than one cat, but above and beyond, there's still one name left over, and that is the name that you never will guess, the name that no human research can discover, but the cat himself knows and will never confess. We notice a cat in a profound meditation. The reason I tell you is always the same. His mind is engaged in a rapt contemplation of the thought, of the thought, of the thought, of his name. He's ineffable.
Her coat is of the tabby.
stripes and leopard spots. All day she sits beneath the stair, or on the step, or on the mat. She sits and sits and sits and sits, and that's what makes a gumby cat. That's what makes a gumby cat.
Shout it.
Or he will do as he did.
And there's an injury.
find myself. No. So you catch me in a rut, it's my ears and put it all on the shelf.
Thank you. visits are occasional to the senior educational, and it is against the rules for any one cat to belong both to that and the joint superior schools. For similar reason, when game is in season, I'm found not at foxes but blimps. I'm frequently seen at the gay stage and screen, which is famous for winkles and shrimps. In the season of Siamese or at the glutton. If I look full of gloom, then I've lunched on the tomb of cabbage, rice pudding, and mutton.
We have no regular ugly participation. We are plausible fellows who like to engage a friendly smelling conversation.
When the feminists settled for Sunday dinner, their minds made up, they wouldn't get thinner.
On Argentine joints,
potato they breathe, cook would appear from behind the scene
and say in a voice that's broken with sorrow, I'm afraid he was waiting at dinner tomorrow. The joint has gone from the oven like that. Then the family said, it's that horrible cat. It was Mungo Jerry.
And Rumpelteazer.
Thank you.
Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicle cats come one, come all. The Jellicle moon is shining bright.
Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball.
Jellicle cats are black and white.
Jellicle cats are rather small.
Jellicle cats
are merry
and bright and pleasant to hear when we catalog.
Cats have cheerful faces.
Jellicle cats have bright black eyes.
We like to practice our airs and graces.
Wait for the Jellicle moon to rise.
Jellicle cats develop slow.
Jellicle cats are not too big.
Jellicle cats are roly-poly.
We know how to dance and we're all happy.
Until the Jellicle moon appear.
We make our toilet and take our repose.
The Jellicles wash behind their ears.
Jellicles dry between their toes.
Jellicle cats are white and black.
Jellicle cats are a moderate size.
Jellicles jump like a jumping jack.
Jellicle cats have moonlit eyes.
We're quiet enough in the morning hours.
It is no more use trying to be traditional as it is trying to be original. It is ultimately the function of art in imposing a credible order upon ordinary reality, and thereby eliciting some perception of an order in reality to bring us to a condition of serenity, stillness, and reconciliation.
No. strong palsy, which makes his paws shake. Yet he was in his youth quite the smartest of cats, but no longer a terror to us and to rats, for he isn't the cat that he was in his prime, though his name was quite famous, he says, in his time. And whenever he joins his friends at the club, which takes place at the back of the neighboring pub, he loves to regale them if someone else pays with anecdotes drawn from his palmiest days. For he once was a star of the highest degree. He has acted likes to relate his success on the halls, where the gallery once gave him 7 catcalls. But his grandest creation, as he loves to tell, was fire for a fiddle, the fiend of the fell.
I've played in my time every possible part, and I used to know 70 speeches by heart. I'd extemporize back chat, I knew how to gag, and I knew how to let the cat out of the bag. I knew how to act with my back and my tail. With an hour of rehearsal, I never could fail. I'd false and would soften the hardest of hearts, whether I took the lead or in character parts. I sat by the bedside of poor little Nell when the curfew was rung. Then I swung on the bell. In the pantomime season, I never fell flat, and I once understudied Dick Whittington's cat. But my grandest creation, as history would tell, was fire from fiddle, the fiend of the fell.
That if someone will give him a toothful of gin, he will tell how he once played a part in Eastland. At a Shakespeare performance, he once mocked a cat. When some actor suggested the need for a cat.
And I say now, these kittens, they do not get trained as we did in the days when Victoria reigned. Never get drained in a regular troop, and they think that they are smart just to jump through a hoop.
And he says as he scratches himself with his claws,
well, the theatre is certainly not what it was. These modern productions are all very well, but there's nothing to equal what I can tell. At a moment of mystery, when I made history, as fire from fiddle, the fiend of the fell. I once played Growl Tiger. could do it again. Could do it again. Could do it again.
Made history. From his ears to the tip of his tail, crawling through the tiniest crack.
He can walk on the narrowest trail. He can play any card from the pack. He is equally cunning with dice. He is always deceiving you into believing that he's only hunting for mice. He can play any trick with a four, four spoon and a bit of fish face. If you look for a knife or a four, and he's given his million his place, you sit on the moon with the man that is gone, but you'll find it next week, flying out along. And we all say,
oh, back to a different jellicle cat life.
Thank you. The street light.